Welcome back to another edition of From V Maths Solution. Today we'll be taking a new topic, which is the real number system. We just have to tackle some issues that most students find it difficult to understand, but we'll be making it very easier for you so that we can all benefit from it. I hope you'll be enjoying this as well as I will. So we go on with the real number system. I guess we understand the word real. When we say something is real, it means it exists in what? Life. So we are going to talk about the numbers that we can use in our daily life activities, which are real to us. In another segment, we'll be talking about numbers that are not real. But today, let's focus on numbers that are real, so that we can enjoy our lesson. Now, as we know early on, we have natural numbers, which we denote with capital N, and they are a set of numbers that start from 1, 2, infinity. We are aware of that. We also have whole numbers, which we have capital W, and they start from 0 to infinity. Also, we have another bigger set, which is integers denoted by Z. And for integers, we have both negative numbers joined with positive numbers, and they move from negative infinity towards positive infinity. After that, we have another bigger set which we call the rational numbers. And rational numbers are numbers that can be written in the form A over B, that's in a fraction form, such a way that B is not equal to 0, and A and B are in their what? Lowest terms, and they all belong to what? Real numbers. And examples are, let's say, minus 5 over 11, 6 over 11, 0.25, now 0.33, and so on and so forth. And if we have rational numbers, we are going to have what? Irrational numbers as well. And we denote irrational numbers with the letter I. They cannot be written in the form A over B. That means they don't have actual word value. They keep changing. And such elements or numbers can be written as square root of non-perfect numbers. For example, square root of 2, square root of 10, pi, the natural e, and so on and so forth. They all form part of what? The irrational numbers. Now, when we add all rational numbers to irrational numbers, we are going to form a bigger set which we call the real number system. So when we find a union of rational numbers and irrational numbers, we get what? The real number system. So we can represent this in a set form. If this larger rectangular box represents all real numbers, then we have one of them representing rational numbers and the other one representing irrational numbers. And within the rational numbers, we can get integers. Within the integers, we can also get whole numbers, And with the whole number, you can also get what? Natural numbers. So that's how the entire numbers in the world can be what? Grouped. Okay, we are good to go, and it's all done here. Now, in our next lesson, we will try to prove whether or not some of these numbers we see here are rational or irrational numbers, and it's quite interesting. So try to get that video, download it as quickly as possible or as you can, so that you can enjoy those proofs. But we'll meet again. It's a very good bye, and thank you for watching our series.